Another incident of gun violence in the U.S. A 12-year-old boy and a 14-year-old girl who ran away from a group home and found guns inside a house they broke into shot at police officers in Volusia County in Florida. The sheriff's office says the girl sustained life-threatening injuries but is now in stable condition. The boy was unhurt but is getting treatment for a medical condition unrelated to the incident. Charges against the children are still pending.
There are three firearms in the house, and there's about 200 rounds of ammunition in the house. So deputies begin to keep eyes on. They call for more resources. They announce their presence. And in fact, they know that we're out there. We're calling for any de-escalation tactic. They reached out to our juvenile justice coordinator to find out who they are. Could we get people on the phone to help us de-escalate? At one point, one of the sergeants got up to the window and threw their personal cell phone in and told them to answer the phone. We want to make contact with you. Nothing worked.
The police officer behind the killing of an elderly woman in Quezon City now facing charges of murder and grave misconduct. But Police Chief Guillermo Eleazar says they will follow due process before dismissing the suspect. That's Master Sergeant Hensi Zidampan. The PNP's investigation is expected to take 3 to 4 weeks. Zidampan shot dead 52-year-old Lilibeth Valdez Monday night. The police officer had a previous squabble with the victim's family.
The firearms and buds, na-confiscate na natin yan. But the result of investigation right now, hindi pa siya tanggal sa serbisyo. Meron tayong due process at ayaw natin i-shortcut yan dahil baka eventually, kagaya ng ibang mga few cases, nababaligtad because of this technicality. So, I don't want to preempt. Otherwise, bakit pa natin i-investigahin yan? Pero sinasabi natin, based on evidence, tingnan natin kung ano magiging resulta ng investigation.
It's the latest senseless killing involving policemen, and Eleazar vows to cleanse the police force.
Hindi ko ipagtatanggol at hindi ako mag-attempt na ipagtanggol yung mga animal ng mga pulis na yan. Ang gusto ko lang sana ipagtanggol, yung more than 220,000 natitira na iba na wala namang basihan para madamay dito. Pag wala ka ng kalokohan at talagang nakita natin na grabe yan, tanggalin, huwag tayong mag-hesitate. Alam mo, we have dismissed more than 5,000 since 2016. At sana nga, hindi na kailangan sana dumating dyan kung hindi lang kumaayos ang recruitment ng mga yan. In my assessment, at sa nakikita kong, well, yung kaya ko lang gawin, I should start from recruitment.
The Philippine Human Rights Commission wants Lilibeth Valdez's killing declared a human rights violation. CHR spokesperson Jacqueline Deguia says they welcome the PNP's filing of charges against Master Sergeant Hensi Zidampan. The CHR is also conducting its own probe into the killing. They also want to give financial assistance to the family of Valdez to encourage them to fight for justice.
This is a small amount, but the message that we wish to convey is that it is a recognition of the government that a wrong has been committed, and we want you to pursue justice. It's a very minimal amount, a maximum of 30,000, and it's more symbolical, we hope. It's supposed to send a message of encouragement.